हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। आई एम डॉक्टर प्रसून दास, जूनियर रेसिडेंट इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द रेडियोलॉजी इन रतन सरकार मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल कोलकाता। टुडे माय पेपर इज ऑन डायग्नोस्टिक एक्यूरेसी ऑफ कॉम्पिटेटिव टोमोग्राफी ऑफ चेस्ट इन इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस इन पीडियाट्रिक पेशेंट इन टर्शियरी केयर हॉस्पिटल रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव स्टडी अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर मॉलय कर्मक हु इज आवर एस्टीम्ड एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन आवर डिपार्टमेंट इन इंस्टीट्यूशन। As you know, in introduction, microbial tuberculosis is the most devastating bacterial pathogen of all time, and the epidemiologic significant mode of transmission is only the airborne, with the infection occurring through the inhalation. Pediatric tuberculosis always occurs by the contact of adult or adolescent, while with cavitary pulmonary tuberculosis, most of it at home or also at school. But contact alone is not sufficient, but immunology genetic factors also is important, and children less than 5 years of age, there's a latex resistance, the disseminated form is much more common, and child-to-child transmission is extremely rare. This pediatric population is typically develop oscillative with difficulties in achieving the definite microbiological conformation, and the microbiological and the manifestations may be the purely the just poor weight gain or the typical TB symptoms, and the radiology presentation is completely different for adult variant. And primary TB, this person any component primary comes in the. The lymphoid pathology is the predominant part of the epidemic TB, is typically not detected by the chest radiograph. For this, we use computed tomography. Also, we can use CT to detect unusual, complicated, or disseminated presentation of the disease. We can also do HCT in miliary tuberculosis associated with that. And we also do the inconclusive chest X-ray findings of the positive tuberculin test. In older children, we can also do CT scan in those patients also. And we also know that CT scan is very much good for detecting the subtle parenchymal disease. The advantage of X-ray is readily available, but the disadvantage of CT is more expensive and require IV contrast. And the dose modulation is very much important. We use weight-based pediatric CT protocol. Aims and objectives, in other words, to compare the CT and chest radiography for diagnostic techniques, we really do confirm the lymphadenopathy, and to discuss the CT findings to evaluate the need for its execution to diagnosis. And the method we take the patient, we retrospectively evaluate the reports from January 2010 to December 2020, the patient less than 16 years diagnosed with active TB in our hospital. And we also recorded on the medical records, demographic analysis, clinical, microbiological, imaging feature, medication outcome also. Inclusion, we include the patient only the less than 16 years of age or having the final diagnosis of actively confirmed probable tuberculosis. We excluded the patients who have only extrapulmonary TB or immunodeficiencies or syndromic approach, but we also exclude the patient with a non-tubercular pulmonary disease also, and the patient who are already on ATT drug, we also excluded from the study. And the MAN2 test was performed for 0.1 ml on the entry part of forum, and the test result greater than 10 ml was considered positive, as you all know. And the examination as superficial with the gastric washing was obtained with 3 consecutive days, and from then the gel lens and culture for microbial tuberculosis was evaluated. Chest X was done on all patients, but CT was done is only on those patients who were only performed after the chest X radiograph, which evaluate the unusual findings or the mass excisions, also the complications like detect complications like airway narrowing or without atelectasis. And the CT examination was performed with the sedated patient younger one, the supine position, and also give and low osmolarity contrast agent, non-ionic contrast agents to establish the mediastinal involvement of tuberculosis. And also statistical analysis was done, the P less than 0.04 considered statistically significant. And we found the results, 41 patients, out of them 20 are male, and 35 were symptomatic. And the most common symptoms were fever, which found in 28 children, and the pulmonary TB was confirmed in 34 patients. And the 4 patients were CT was not performed because the parents did not give consent. And there are several types of consolidation. The more commonly consolidated segmental pattern was found in 15 cases. And there are other varieties, nodular and lower varieties also found. And the nodules, the parenchymal nodules are found in 13 cases, 3 in 5 cases, and the lymphadenopathy was 33 children on CT. And this lymphadenopathy, we found that the only 6 patients were lymphadenopathy, at least one lymphadenopathy greater than 20 mm, which is significant, and the 9 patients were lymphadenopathy less than 10 mm. And microbiological confirmed case in 4 patients having the lymphadenopathy greater than 20 mm. are also evaluated also the lymph node enhancement or contrast enhancement. So the most commonly classic ring enhancement pattern also is there. There is found only the four children, tail children, but for the homogeneous enhancement, also found the calcifications were found. Calcified present 5 children less than 5 years. The most more common is the point types of calcification. These are the chart we found the CTs and find consolidation, nodules, central lobular patterns, or central lobular nodules, stream but appearance. This is the right side, the lymphadenopathy types like ring lymphadenopathy, ring enhancement, homogeneous and the calcification pointed or shield or the size, and also the lymphadenopathy only pathological findings. And this is the picture, the high-year-old patient, completely malnourished boy, confirmed TB patient, and chest X-ray, there is an oblique opacity leg upper lobe, and followed by confirmed by CT. And also there is subcranial region, a prominent lymph node. And another one, this is a coronary enhancement mediastinal lymphadenopathy noted, and with necrosis, and there is a computed tomography, a contrast enhancement for the peripheral consolidation, the left lower lobe also. And this is an 8-year-old who is in recurrent lung infections with cough. This found is a consolidation of the volume loss in the left lower lobe, right middle lobe. And also there is a finding the left pulmonary hilum is compressed with the bronchial compression is done. We have seen because adenopathy in the left pulmonary hilum. And this is also the cavitary lesion, which cavitary lesion in the apex in the right lung is correspond with the CT. And in the discussion, we found that the children, younger patients with physiological thymic protrusion limits the projection of the plain radiograph. So the enlarged lymphadenopathy only projected, only prevalent, only when projected over the heart and the thymus. And the lateral projection improved, but this projection is not always easy to perform with children. So CT is useful, is there. The most commonly anomaly found in CT is an adenopathy. The 89% of them, 81 as a higher one, followed by lower paratracheal region. And our study, the most common pattern of enhancement was homogeneous contrast enhancement, followed by peripheral ring enhancement. And one single case of inhomogeneous enhancement. This is the also the study with Mukun study, but the most commonly pattern was inhomogeneous. So this is contrary to our finding. In our study, seven children was evaluated by the seven children. Show cavitation. So we know the cavitation is a high infective, high bacterial load. So it is a typical feature of adult type, which also we seen all the children type is less rare one. And last pattern was parenchymal lesion with the miliary TB was found in our in four children. Four children, three of them are less than 5 years. So also we know that the immunity was less in that patient. So in our study, the pleural involvement is found in 9 patients. 3 patients with pulmonary effusion, 6 patients pleural thickening. Sorry, 3 patients pleural effusion, 6 patients with pleural thickening is noted. And this conclusion is the delayed diagnosis of the TB patient usually due to the failure to highlight and the mediastinal lymphadenopathy. And CT scan of chest for the advantage of the conventional radiograph diagnosis pediatric patients. And the limitations are that this retrospective nature. So and the use of chest CT based on physician decision, but not the standardized local protocols. So in addition to the contribution diagnosis TB, TBM, CT also provides the information about the management of TB. So evaluating the disease activity and when it is a complicated form of TB. This is my references, 7 references. Thank you.